I'm Diane Resignola with NAREIT. In conjunction with NAREIT's REIT Week, I'm here today with Brent Smith, President and CEO of Piedmont Office Realty Trust. Brent, how are you today?
I'm doing great, thank you.
What post-COVID changes do you think will be unique to office REITs specifically?
We clearly anticipate some changes in the office sector. Some are common to all environments, while others I do think are more unique to office. Obviously, across all real estate, there is a heightened sense of awareness around sanitation and cleanliness. And as an example, we have cleaning crews cycling throughout our properties every 2 hours, cleaning restrooms, break rooms, copier areas, lobbies, and really any other high traffic areas. And our employees and vendors are wearing masks, and we're encouraging our tenants to do so as well, again, especially in those high traffic areas. We've installed additional touchless devices indoors and in promoting social distancing throughout and encouraging that in our buildings, limiting the number of passengers in elevators and adding destination dispatch capabilities where possible. You know, I think specific to the office sector, there will be a reversal of the densification trend to more emphasis on air, light, and space for employees. In addition, we believe locations that are mass transit dependent will be less attractive. While locations with ample parking, direct highway access, outdoor amenities, and the like will be probably more attractive. And then finally, I believe we'll see a customer trend similar to what we've seen for sustainability, but even incorporating that to a greater focus on a building's wellness factors as well.
Piedmont's website currently includes a pop-up letter from you, thanking frontline workers as well as your customers, and pointing readers to your corporate social responsibility and charitable giving program. Why is it so important to make this message so prominent during this time?
The men and women at Piedmont believe it's always important to recognize individuals who selflessly serve others, but particularly during times of uncertainty, like those brought on by this health crisis. So my colleagues and I have witnessed incredible courage and compassion across our markets where we make our homes, and from our first line responders to healthcare professionals, the grocery store workers or municipal employees, and even just, you know, the delivery drivers, these individuals are deserving of our thanks and praise. And at the same time, we also recognize that others in our communities are in dire need, children missing their school lunches, the homeless are in great need of additional assistance, and numerous local charities are struggling from decreased donations. My hope is that while we are sheltering in place and caring for our families and trying our best to adapt to new ways of doing business and education, that we remind our constituents that we're very blessed and we must support those that are making an even greater sacrifice for us all. And I hope we have, in a small way, encouraged people to lift each other up and support each other across our communities.
Piedmont has issued a Returning to the Workplace Tenant Guide, in which you outline how the company is coordinating with tenants and contractors to enact new operational procedures. Can you talk a bit about the process of putting this together and its key elements?
We've gone, just like everyone else in experiencing something that none of us have, creating a new path forward, if you will. And so that really involved bringing together multiple components of our team. We created a COVID-19 strategic committee to focus on the impacts of the pandemic on not only property operations, but really across the firm. And I want to commend the incredibly talented group of men and women at Piedmont who worked tirelessly on that committee throughout this pandemic. As our highest priority, like every other business, is the safety and well-being of our customers, employees, and vendors. And we've worked diligently to prepare our buildings to be ready to welcome our employees back into the workplace. In addition, our deep relationships really across the real estate industry has allowed us to gather best practices for that return to work component under these unusual circumstances. We're following guidelines from the CDC and other prominent experts to ensure our practices that we're using are kept up to date as information evolves. And we're more importantly collaborating with our tenants to provide a roadmap for them coming back to the buildings, but also to ensure that we're doing it in an organized manner and answering the questions that they may have and alleviating concerns. Some key components to our handbook include going through the extensive signage that throughout our buildings enforcing CDC safe practices and social distancing, the use of face masks and foot traffic circulation, both in common areas and in helping our tenants evaluate their own suites. aggressive and visible cleaning and disinfecting protocols that are put in place now on a regular basis throughout the day, multiple times a day, limiting gatherings in conference rooms, cafes, and kitchen areas, and coordinating teams, again, as I mentioned, with our tenants for staggered arrival times, again, helping to promote social distancing. We've tried to think through a lot of these kind of routine processes that we took for granted and how to adapt them for this new world.
How will the pandemic change the use of real estate in your sector overall?
I think that's a difficult question to answer today, but we certainly are starting to have glimpse of what that might be. So while it's too early to tell, I think for office, we continue to monitor the landscape and engage with and listen to our tenants to understand their needs, both today and what we see down the road and tomorrow. You know, in the short term, I think users are going to pause, reflect on their space inventory. Not only the obvious issues like redefining the density of a floor plan and spatial boundaries, but also actual physical locations of their offices. We do believe the recent trend of more employees per square foot will likely reverse, offset potentially by some tenants finding that working from home will work beyond just the period of this crisis for certain roles. That said, I don't think we subscribe to a widespread adoption of work from home. And while it's proven to work well in some instances, we really believe and see it now, the need for social interaction and team building to reinforce a company's culture and provide an environment that collaborates efficiently to foster new ideas. These are critical, and I applaud the various technology and applications which we're utilizing during this time, but technology simply can't replicate certain elements which I think are vital to people and successful companies.
Brent, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you, Diane. Appreciate it. Stay safe.
For more from REIT Week, visit REIT.com.